Hi, and welcome to Tech Adventure. We are back with the MagSafe battery pack, or iPhone battery pack, whichever one you want to call it, like I said. But I do want to talk to you about what I recommend, if I recommend it, or the bad and the good things as well. So starting off with a couple bad things, this does only charge at 5 watts, so you do have to know that it doesn't charge at 15 watts like the regular MagSafe puck, the one that you can buy for the phone with the 20 watt adapter. So it's only 5 watts that it does it, but I'm guessing they did that on purpose so it doesn't heat up your phone, which brings me up to the next one. It does heat up your phone, but I'm guessing that's only because it's a wireless charger on top of your phone and you're using it. So that's also probably why they kind of limited the charge to 5 watts, which also because it is limited, I've noticed it doesn't go higher than 90% or 91% sometimes when you're using it, when you have it on your phone and it's like below and you're just giving it a little bit of the juice. As well as you can actually, or what I've experienced with the Pro Max, is you can actually use the phone more than how, or than more than the battery pack is charging, which I guess at that point, there's no point in having a battery pack on your phone, but I have noticed it does give you extra juice, so, I mean, it is a battery pack. But another thing that does kind of make it annoying for the Pro Max especially is it does, as you see, show you when you put it on there, does get really, really thick. So as you see there, there's the phone, gets way thicker, as well as it gets much heavier because this is a full battery pack on top. It is only 1460, but it does, you do kind of feel the heft on there, as well as you can see how I grip it. It kind of feels weird right there on the back, especially how there's a little lip here and a little lip there. Now with the 12 and the 12 Pro and obviously the Mini, it's going to be much better. The Mini is going to be the best since it's going to probably, actually I felt it, it fits perfectly around this MagSafe battery, so you won't have to worry about it feeling weird, but it will obviously still give it much more thickness and much more weight. So yeah, those are the negatives that I've noticed with it. There are a lot more positives, to be honest. It does obviously give you extra battery life. That's kind of an obvious state since it's a battery pack, but I do want to say that because like I said before, you can use your phone faster than it can charge it, but you do get that extra. I have noticed like with it, that by the end of the day, if I have it kept on from the beginning of the day, I'll be at like with heavy use at still like 60%. While if I weren't using it, then it'd be like more like 30% or less. That's on a heavy day. Now on a good day where I used it medium or maybe even light, I'd be at home with like 90%. So I thought it was amazing, and I'm pretty sure it'd even be better with the 12 Pro and 12, and then the 12 Mini as well, especially that they're smaller. And it would probably charge them better, way better than the Pro Max. But I just had the Pro Max, so I did test it mostly with that one. Another thing is, it is much smaller than most other ones you can find out there. Like, I know Anker's one is like twice the size of it, which, I mean, it would be good for the Pro Max. Like I said, if they did have a bigger one for this one, then I would recommend it for the Pro Max. But because this is a little bit small, it'd probably be better for the smaller phones or even just the regular Pro. As well as, so speaking of the size, because of this size, it does fit well on the iPhone Mini. So I put it on an iPhone Mini and it feels amazing, just because it fits perfectly around on it. The edges of the MagSafe battery pack will actually fit perfectly with the edges of the new iPhone 12 Mini. So that's one thing that will really, I don't know, it's something about it that it just aligns perfectly and there's no, you know, like I said right here, part that, you know, goes over, which, you know, you don't like when you have just something there on a phone, so it would be better on the iPhone Mini. Now, another thing, you can choose to use this as just a regular wireless charger, so if you were to just plug it in, you can keep this by your bed, somewhere, and then have some, as like a wireless charger, have something on there, and you can either plug in your iPhone 12, or you can just have it on your iPhone 12, and then it will charge both. Now, what's really cool is you can actually choose which one you want to plug it into. So you can plug it into the cable or the port of the phone or the port of the MagSafe right there. So either one you plug into at night, it will charge both of them, which makes you think, does that mean the iPhone has wireless or reverse wireless charging? Maybe it does and they just haven't turned it on. You never know, but that's something to keep in mind. As well as like AirPods, you can put AirPods on there and you don't even need it to be plugged in, to be honest. So you can use like an iPhone 11, an iPhone 10, anything that has wireless charging, even a Samsung, you can probably put on there and it will charge. Now, with most Androids, obviously, the batteries are huge, so this probably wouldn't really charge it that much, you know, because they have like 5,000 milliamp batteries out there now with Android, which is crazy, but yeah, you got that. Now, you can also use this plugged in. Like I said, you can plug it in on the on your countertop or something like that, even say in a kitchen. Now, this isn't water resistant, but you can probably plug it in a kitchen, you know, like I said, next to your bed, use it as just a wireless charger or without the plug as well. So you got that as well. Now, probably my favorite part about it, now this will only work with an iPhone 12 or 12 Pro or 12 Pro Max, but as soon as you slap it on there, it will show you this. You saw it in my unboxing where it will charge your phone and it shows you how much the percentage is, and this will continue on. If you go to battery, let's see here, there it is, there's the battery, so it will continue showing you as it goes down, as well as your phone as it goes up. You also have the other ones as well. That's my watch, but if you have something connected, you'll see it there as well. Now, my favorite part is, even when it's dead, it actually still shows it. So it will tell you that it's dead, and it will show that it's there, which is kind of cool, just to let you know that it is dead. So you can either, if your phone is still good and you still have other things to do, you just take it off, plug it in, charge it, or just take it off because it gives bulk to your phone anyways. So there you go. But yeah. That is pretty much everything about that I've noticed it. If you were wanting to buy one of these, here's what I would recommend. If you have an iPhone 12 Pro Max, I don't think it's worth it because even without it, I did last the whole day with the battery life, even with heavy use of the regular 12 Pro Max. If you have a 12 Pro or a 12, you can go for it. I would recommend it for it. It would probably be much better, but you can probably get a wireless charging power bank that will probably be bigger, and if you want to probably charge even more than this one. But I would recommend it for the 12 and 12 Pro. The 12 Mini, just go ahead and buy it. If you have the 12 Mini, I guarantee you will love this one. It fits perfectly well on it. It will probably charge it at least one time and a half. So I would definitely recommend it for the iPhone 12 Mini. Now, if you were to just, like I said in the beginning of the video, just use it as like a thing to charge on your counter or something like that. Like I said, it charges at max of 5 watts. That's only for backup. I just say that because it's a cool thing you can use it for. But yeah. But yeah, that is my verdict. Thank you guys very much for watching. You have a great day or night whenever you're watching this.